What's going on, you all? This is Brother D here coming back at you with another edition of the Brother D Show podcast. And on tonight's show, we will be talking from the subject, it is your time. It is your time. So now many of us might have come up in a household or come up in a situation to where we felt like we were at a disadvantage. We might have felt as though we had one primary parent in the home. Another parent was not really as active. Some people might feel as though their disadvantage was they could have come up in a abusive household, whether it be physically abusive or emotionally abusive. Some people might have come up in any given situation to where they feel like life threw them a bad curveball, or life dealt them a bad hand. But no matter what your disadvantage was or currently is, I want you to know that it is your time. Whether or not you finished college, whether or not you matriculated into a specific university of your choice, and if you feel as though you didn't really make an impact, or if you feel as though your life really didn't pan out in the way that other people's lives did, don't fret and don't feel ashamed or embarrassed about your disadvantage. Don't feel ashamed or embarrassed about how you came up. Because when you have gone through a lot in your life, when you've gone through traumatic events and situations, you might feel as though you were at a disadvantage, and that could be true. But I don't want your beginning. I don't want what you had to go through to cause you to believe that you can't make it or that your time will never show up. I've come to talk to somebody and let somebody know, yes, the abuse was hurtful. Yes, not having both parents in the household might have messed you up a little bit. But no matter how many obstacles presented themselves to you, I want you to know that you can make it. And guess what? It is your time. Why do I say it's your time? It's your time because you've seen other people go forth ahead of you. It's your time because you have dealt with so many storms. You've dealt with so many adversities. Even things that you don't want to talk about. Even things that are hard for you to really explain to other people. Life has handed you different blows and has given you different hits. And sometimes you sat there in your house and you said, why me? Why do I gotta be in a place where all these different things have happened to me? And the next person didn't have to go through as much as I did. But I got the scars to prove it. I got my stripes. I got my scars to prove that I've gone through a lot. To prove that I've been through hell and high water. I got my scars. But why did these things have to happen to me? Why is the question that you ask yourself? Why did I see other people come up in a beautiful household? And why was the mother and the father in the house? Why did they the parents show up to their kids, their son and their daughter's graduation? But how come my parent couldn't have been there for mine? For somebody, when you join the basketball league, you expected both parents to be in the stands, but they were not there. You expected to have one big happy family, but it didn't happen. And there are times where you said, I don't even know why this is happening to me. And you felt embarrassed and you said, I feel like other people are sitting back laughing and saying, woe is him. Woe is her. Oh, well, we see what they're going through. But you know what? We got to get back home and we got to enjoy our family. We got to enjoy our life. But this is what I want you to grab from today's show. If you don't grab anything else, I want you to know that you got the scars to prove for a fact that you've been through hell and high water, but you made it. And guess what? The scars and all that stuff that you went through, it gave you an advantage that those people will never be able to have. Believe it or not, they will not be able to say, I know what he went through. I know what she went through, because they didn't go through it. You got the battle scars, which now means you are a source of credibility. And now you're in a place where you can relate to other people. You can teach other people. You've now gone through the hell. So now you can build up an audience of people who can understand what you've gone through. They can relate to what you've gone through. And now guess what? You have an advantage over those people who didn't go through all that stuff. You know how to speak a certain language that you would not have known how to speak if you didn't go through the hell. You wouldn't have a voice. You wouldn't have a story if you didn't go through it. So even when you were younger and when you thought that you was at a disadvantage, today I want you to understand that those people are now at a disadvantage. It's them. I'm talking about the people who you know who got fed with a silver spoon in their mouth, who had everything that they wanted to have, who didn't really go through much. And by the outward appearance, it might have looked like they had such a great life, but you don't know what they're going through behind the scenes. But at the same time, they really don't know what you've gone through behind the scenes. So sometimes your exterior might come across as too rough or too brash. But hey, you're just saying, I'm just straightforward. I don't know how else to be. I'm straightforward with my stuff. I can't sugarcoat anything because I'm straightforward to it. I'm just to the point. And that's how you have to be. They might have gone through stuff behind the scenes, but they don't know what you've gone through behind the scenes either. And I'm talking about the people who acted like they were better than you because they didn't experience what you experienced. They had everything that they wanted. Those people who sat there and who just acted as though, well, I'm all of that. I got this. I got that. I accomplished this. I'm driving this car. I met this girl. I met this guy, and I'm making X amount of figures a year. And you're sitting there struggling, saying, "How am I going to pay all my bills?" Even though on the outside it might look like they're doing better than you, just know you got something on the inside of you that could change a whole lot of people. Your story is not theirs, and their story is not yours, but you got something. I'm talking about the people who went through the real rough stuff, the real hard stuff to deal with for the average person. You got something in you that nobody can deny, that nobody can take away from you. Nobody can, even if they wanted to. They can't take your story from you. They can't take your stripes from you. They can't. They cannot take it. Because you know for a fact that if they went through what you went through, they would not have made it. They wouldn't have come out with their right mind. They wouldn't have come out in a place where they're in a well state of mind. For example, what I'm trying to explain to you is they would not have been in a place where they could still be able to function and go on throughout their life the same way that you can. You have a strength, you have a boldness, you have a determination that they don't possess. Maybe in their own way, but not in the same way that you do. It's not the same. It's not the same. You have an advantage that they don't have today. And I want you to understand that after all the hell that you went through, it's your time now. It's your time to do what? It's your time to soar. It's your time to go further in your life. It's your time to birth that book if you feel like you want to birth the book. It's your time to get that promotion on your job. It's your time to expand, to travel. It's your time to make your voice heard. Get your story out. Launch your business. Go out here and let somebody know that they can make it. Because I made it, you can make it. It's your time now to win. Whatever your definition of winning is, it's your time. You watch other people go ahead of you, but now it's your time. And it's your turn to have the best. You have to soar. You have to put together a plan. And you have to begin to write things down and say, what are the steps that I'm going to take in order for me to win? I encourage somebody listening to me. Say, you know what? Write down what your definition of winning looks like. And after you write that down, you can say, you know what? Now, these are the steps that I'm going to take in order for me to get there. What's your definition of winning? And what are the steps that you're going to take in order for you to win? Write it down on a piece of paper or on your smartphone or on your tablet. You know why? Also, it's your time to win. Why it's your time to go forward? Because guess what? You have to be convinced for a fact that you didn't go through all what you went through for no apparent reason. Like I was just telling you, you have a story to share. You have things that can benefit somebody else who's about to go through what you came out of. Who's about to experience what you experienced before in the past. You have something that you can share with them that's going to help to encourage them, that's going to help to spruce them up, that's going to help to speak life into them. None of what we go through is just random. It's to help the next person who might be struggling, who might be going through a whole lot, who might feel overwhelmed. Your story can help deliver and can help to bring somebody else out. And break something that's on the inside of them. It can help to break a mindset that they have. They might need to hear a different perspective. They might need to hear you break something down.